I hope you will hear my story and others like it and realize that abortion care is crucial and should be free and accessible to every person. When I learned that my husband and I were expecting a baby girl, I dreamed of her running around my childhood home in Idaho, digging in the dirt with grandpa and baking in the kitchen with grandma. I couldn't wait. On September 5th, 2012, we went for our 16-week sonogram. We squeezed each other's hands when we heard her little heartbeat. We watched with wonder as the technician measured and commented on each little body part, but soon she grew silent. As she left, she said the doctor would be in to talk about the diagnosis. Diagnosis? We looked at each other. The doctor came in, sat on an office chair, and rolled over to the exam table. She spoke softly. Our baby was missing an arm bone, the ulna. She was measuring very small, too small. She had extreme skeletal dysplasia and her lungs would never grow large enough to survive. The diagnosis? Thanatophoric dysplasia, incompatible with life. At home, still in shock, we pored over our laptops to research everything we could find out about thanatophoric dysplasia. We found that even if she survived to term, she would live in uncontrollable pain and only with extreme intervention. There were very few cases where the baby lived longer than a few hours. We looked at each other and we knew. We had to make a decision as her parents. We had to protect her from life. On Friday, September 14th, 2012, my husband and my best friend sat with me as we checked into the hospital. The nurses were thoughtful and warm as they wheeled me into the operating room. And I remember thinking how painful and how incredibly sad it would be for me to carry the baby full term and see people at work and have people come up to me and talk, you know, when's the baby due? Those kind of questions would have been, I don't know if I could have recovered emotionally from taking the baby full term. I know some people might make that choice and may have hope that there can be a miracle, but for me, I wanted to care for her and then move on with my life. We were terrified that we wouldn't be able to have a successful pregnancy. We didn't know when or how to try again, if it would happen again. So we had, you know, really stressful pregnancies after that. I now have two beautiful children. But what I know is that having a baby is not the safest thing in the world. When my second daughter was born, I had a uterine rupture, excuse me, and it was really traumatic. And so I've kind of experienced that moment. And looking around in my OB's office and talking to the geneticist that we met with and all of the other doctors, you could see the stress in their face as we were considering taking it to term, and they said that there had been another woman who did a while prior and that it had been traumatic for everyone, not just the mother. The doctors still suffered because it was just so hard. And I mean, I was so lucky that I didn't have to hide it. There was no stigma really because we had this fatal diagnosis. So I can't even imagine if I were making choices and felt like I didn't have a support system to talk to or friends that would, you know, support me. It just, it would have been such a different situation. And, you know, I knew that, like, even if we had to go to a different state or, you know, another country, like, my parents could help me do that. And I mean, it's important to remember that probably everyone out there knows someone who's had an abortion and loves someone who's had an abortion. And when you say things that are negative about that, they don't dare come to you. They don't dare share. And I hope that my example can help someone else find their voice.